Good evening. Tonight we report from Canberra on the most unlikely and unexpected general election victory in modern Australian history. For 2 years, poll results showed the coalition headed for defeat at the hands of Labor. But Brett, no one expected this.
Janice, no one at all. And today, Labor and the coalition admitted that they were really expecting this to be a Labor victory, but that wasn't the case. And even very early on last night, we began to see that things were going the coalition's way. This really was a high-risk election strategy by Labor, and Scott Morrison really capitalised on that, and also Bill Shorten's personal unpopularity. Let's take a look at the state of the 46th Parliament here in Canberra this evening. And right now, the Electoral Commission is projecting that the Coalition will have 77 seats for an absolute majority, while Labor will have 68. There are three independents, and the Katter Party and the Centre Alliance and the Greens each have one. In the Senate, well, things are far more complicated. It was only a half-Senate election, and final results aren't expected for some time, and neither the Coalition nor Labor is expected to have a majority.
A victory to savour.
How good is Australia?
For those in the coalition who kept the faith.
I have always believed in miracles, and tonight we've been delivered another one.
Embraced by stunned supporters and his mentor, John Howard. Scott Morrison delivering Liberals one of the most unlikely election wins in a generation.
These are the quiet Australians who have won a great victory tonight.
A victory that caught even the First Family by surprise as they watched the results together at Kirribilli House.
I'm very excited, I'm very honoured, and I'm very humbled.
Well, it was a miracle. There was a lot of prayer going up for Scott around the country.
Despite some high-profile coalition casualties.
And Scott Morrison will now quite rightly enter the Liberal pantheon forever.
The predicted swing to Labor didn't eventuate, leaving true believers in a state of despair.
I feel sick in my stomach of how the Liberals can actually form government.
Bill Shorten unable to sway the Australian public after 6 years as opposition leader. Friends. Conceding he'd lost what many here believed was the unlosable election.
I want to say beyond this room to Australians who supported Labor, I know that you're all hurting, and I am too.
Immediately standing down as leader after a marathon campaign and the death of Labor giant Bob Hawke.
I wish we could have done it for Bob, but it was not to be. Labor's next victory will belong to our next leader, and I'm confident that victory will come at the next election.
An autopsy underway into the opposition's failed election manifesto, centred on franking credits, negative gearing and climate change.
I'm proud of that. I'm actually proud of the fact that we ran a bold agenda. I'm disappointed that the scare campaigns bit in the way they did.
The Treasurer making good on one election pledge.
Cheers, guys.
Cheers, guys. Cheers, guys.
To shout the bar if the government hung on to power.
Who says politicians don't keep their promises?
Toasting the success of the coalition's third leader in 3 years.
Scott Morrison has shown himself to be a fantastic leader and a fantastic Prime Minister. And he has won this election.
Malcolm Turnbull offering his congratulations on an outstanding personal victory. Emerging this morning with a smile, there was a warm welcome for the Morrisons at church this morning.
I give thanks to live in the greatest country in all the world.
Before heading to Shark Park.
How good is that win? How good is that win? Well done.
This afternoon.
Yes, the miracle man himself, the Prime Minister.
Bill Shorten leaving his election party through a side door.
Hello, everyone.
Arriving home knowing his dream of leading the nation was over.
There's lots of lessons for Labor to learn from yesterday's result, and I know that my party will.
As Scott Morrison secures a second term after just 267 days in office.
I said that I was going to burn for you, and I am, every single day.